G'day guys, welcome back. I'm gonna go again with the 3D bloom on my poinsettia mold. Now I have got something in those two there, so I'm just gonna use these two. And I've got my resin made up. Just gonna check its little temperature. Before I started the video, it was 38, but I want it to get to 40. I'm trying to hold this so you can see. I want it to get to 40 degrees. What's that say? 39.2, 39.9. Go, you good thing. 40.5 Celsius. Okay, so that's the magic number. Let me just clean my little probe off with some alcohol. Just don't want that getting covered in resin. All right, folding back up. So, 40 degrees. This is the Platinum 360 Plus. I'm just gonna spray my mold with some alcohol. Try not to get on that one. So I'm just gonna pour some in here. Pour some in here. And then I'm just gonna grab 30 grams. I just need 30 grams or 1 ounce. Do this upside down. Look at my scale. Grubby, I need a new one. That's full of resin and paint. About, I don't actually need 30. Last time I did it, oh, let's go for 30. 1 ounce. There we go, close enough. 28 grams. 1 ounce. And then the rest of what's in here, I'll put in there. So I just made up 80 grams of A and 37 grams of B of the Platinum 360 Plus. You know, I've been using it a lot lately for pretty much everything. It's a very good all-rounding resin. And it sets up real quick so I can demold later on today, which is lovely. And it doesn't do the amine blush. You know that oil slick thing that you can get on the top of some resins? And you may notice some of your resins, like on the bottle, it's got this like white crusty stuff around the bottle. If it does that, you know it's going to do the amine blush. But this one doesn't, which is great. Just going to torch that for bubbles. Righto, so I'm going to drop my inks and then and make up my white, and then I'm going to wait till the resin in here gets to back up to 40 degrees, because now that I've decanted it into a shallow cup and a shallow coaster there, it will stop rising and probably actually cool down a bit. So now I'm going to wait until it comes back up. So I thought I'd do some brown, that's coffee, tangerine and yellow. These are all by Decorom, D-E-C-O-R-O-M, just a cheapie from Amazon. Put a drop in there. I find that some of the other inks don't spread very well for me. And then I also get this like skin. I definitely get the skin from the pinata. I'm gonna go with the yellow first and do the outside, and then I'll fill up the inside with the orange. All right, so here we go. I really like this mold. I like how it's got the five rounds on it. Not too busy. Easy to pour into because it's got five nice big petals that you can pour into. Don't know what that is. Bit of brown maybe. Okay, so that's my yellow. I may revisit the yellow. So I don't have to rush. I've got about 5 to 10 minutes before the resin in there starts getting hot again. Now I don't want to put too much color in. I always find I add more and I add more, and then I lose the color of the white petals, you know, if you put too much in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There we go. All right, I think that'll do. I think that will do. I don't want to overdo it. All right, so that's my That's my ink. I will kind of swirl them in a bit, just to blend them a little bit. But let's get on to the white. So the white, I'm using the Just Resin Titanium White. Any white paste will do. I think they work all the same, really, from what I've seen. I'm just going to dip it in, give it a stir, wipe the bottom, wipe the top, whatever's left on. It's a little bit left on the side there. Whatever's left on is staying in. That's all I'm using in an ounce of resin. And now, four drops. One, two, three, four drops of Pinata White Alcohol Ink. You can hardly see that it says Pinata anymore. All right, let's stir that up. And then, basically, I just need to wait until this gets back up to 40. It's nice and warm. If your resin isn't getting warm, it's not ready for you to pipe your white, okay? It'll just sink straight down and you'll have blobbies. Someone called them globbies the other day on Facebook. I thought that was really cute. Blobs, blobbies. I guess they could be globs as well. I just call them blobs. Because they're blobs of paste that's fallen through to the back. And you'll get that if your white, clear resin is too thin, because it can't sustain the weight of this white paste. It'll just sink right through. So wait until it's nice and warm and toasty. You can feel it. It's warmer than body temperature. And you need to pipe a pretty decent thick line too. If you're piping little thin lines, it's not going to spread. Because if you've got a really tiny thin line, it can only spread maybe double. Whereas if you pipe a thick line, it's going to spread like double or more. So probably triple. So make sure you pipe a nice thick line, okay? I think that's everything I need to tell you. I tell you this every time, but not everybody watches all my videos, I guess. So, let's take its temperature again and just see what it's doing. We'll see if we can get back up to 40. 34, 35, 36, 37. This is Celsius. 38. 'Alright, so I've got a couple of minutes to wait. So in the meantime, I will give this a swirl. Just using my little silicone tipped pen there. Get my paper towel organized for piping. I'm going to use a piping bag for these because I'm just going to do circles. I have been dipping and doing dashes, but today I'm just going to do the old-fashioned piping. Now I might leave the, I might not put too much orange in with the brown. Like so. All right, let's wipe that off. And then the orange again, into the yellow a little bit, right up to the edges, back in. And a little bit into the brown. There we go. Looks pretty, doesn't it? So I don't think you need too much. I really don't need too much color. Well, for me anyway. Sometimes I do too much and it's so bright. You can't even see your petals anymore. All right, now what's my time? 1 o'clock. I stopped stirring at 12:40. I decanted it about 10 minutes after that, or maybe not. I don't know what time I decanted. I just went by the time, by the temperature. So now it's 1 o'clock. So that has been 20 minutes. So I usually do it at either 20 or 25 minutes. Depends on the temperature in my room. My room's 26 at the moment. When I did my other one this morning, it was 23, and I piped at 25 minutes. But because it's warmer in here, I think my resin's going to warm up faster. What does that say? I'm looking at it upside down. 39.8. Oops. Put the stick back in. 40.4. Okay. So we are good to go. So that's with this particular resin, the Platinum 360 Plus. It pretty much is available worldwide now. I'm just cleaning off my stick, bear with me. Pretty much available worldwide now. So I've got the link for Platinum down in my description. You can order off their website. If they're not in your country, feel free to email them. They're very obliging. They might even be able to send you some. But yeah, the 360 Plus would be my suggestion, just because you can do so much with it. You can do regular coasters, you can do sculptures, you know, in your bowls, you can do the 3D bloom. You can do top coats because it's a doming resin. It's lots and lots of uses. Anyone would think I got a commission from them, hey? I don't. They do send me free resin, but, and I love it, so. Always a bonus, isn't it, when you get a little freebie? Kidney and resin helps me a lot. Alrighty. Now, I just get these little piping bags from eBay. They usually have a small, medium, and a large, like in packs of 100. I just go for the small one. And I cut the end off too because it's too big. You don't need all that hanging off the edge. Okay, so put that there. Now, I'm stuck. Get out. I wound my glove up. I'm going to write this down. 1202. All right, so I'm going to cut. When you look at it, there's like the resin at the end and then there's a clear bit. I usually go halfway between where the resin ends and the little clear point. You want a nice thick line. Okay, are we ready? Here we go. And you want your resin to sit on top. If it sinks, it's not ready. Go slowly, try and do a nice thick line. Don't rush too much and have a thin line. Nice thick line. You find if you go too fast, it can't you pull on the resin? And then it thins out. So just go slow. Keep it at the same thickness of line if you can. All right, let's go with the next one. Whoops, there's a big blob in the middle. That's okay, because I'm going to swirl the center anyway. Concentrating. So this was 22 minutes for me today. The one this morning was 25 minutes. I haven't unmolded it yet, so I can't say if it worked. Whoops, I went over the top. Do another little one in there. Oh no, it's not raining. Oh, I just hung my washing out earlier. Don't you hate that? Just gonna pop that in there like so. Go away, rain. Dear, oh dear. Too late. All my washing's soaked. Probably could have got it half an hour, 10 minutes ago. Now, see the little blobbies? There's a hair on that. Just smooth them in, because you don't want a big blob. Because it can be heavy, and it can fall down. So, if you can see your little blobby, just try and break it up a bit. Looks like it's blooming already. Yay. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go out to the points and into the petals. All right, so in. Go away, rain. Oh no. It's always the way, isn't it? You think, I must get the washing in. I'll do it after the video, after I've made my video, and then it's too late. So you can see there into the points, I've kind of pulled a little bit of that orange through from the center. So that looks quite nice, doesn't it? So here we go, in from the petals. So I'm hoping to maybe still have a little bit of white on the edges, a little bit, and then up like so. Oops, and hopefully this will look pretty. I'm going probably about halfway into my resin. It's not touching the bottom, it's going about halfway. All right, so let's just start in the middle and come back to the middle with a little swirl. Start in the middle, come back to the middle, and up. And hopefully that will be pretty. I just wanted a slight dark center, you know, like a sunflower. You know how a sunflower's got that sort of brown, the big brown center, and then it's got the pale petals on the outside. That's kind of what is in my little head. All right, give that a torch. I'm not going to give it any heat from my heat gun. Just torching for bubbles. Smooth that over. Give my little silicone brush a wipe with a baby wipe. Clean it up. And that's it. That's it. That was pretty easy, wasn't it? All right, let's hope it works. Now, that was my last resin pour in my studio. So I will try to keep doing some more. If it doesn't rain all day tomorrow, they'll pull the roof off my garage. But I will try and do some, but I will be working in my kitchen on my kitchen bench. So let's have a little peek at that. And then, I should have zoomed you in, shouldn't I? Sorry, keep forgetting. Could have, once I've finished mixing. Oh, don't look at that. That's a different video. All right, here we go round. Round, round, round. Oh, that one's probably up already anyway, so it won't matter. That video's probably up already before this one. I'll have to stand here to get away from that ring light. Alrighty, let's have a little peek. Why won't you focus? Oh gosh. Okay, the ring light just went off. I must have stood on the cable. That's probably better, isn't it? Yeah, we don't need my ring light. Look at the colours. Don't they look pretty? Oh my gosh, I'm so sick of this phone. Oh. They do updates and then they're never the same, are they? I think I have to move slowly to focus. I think it like focuses every 3 seconds or something like that. So if you move too quickly, you can't focus. Ah, stupid phone. Oh gosh. All right, so there's the little brown center. Hopefully it will look nice on the other side. These are blooming beautifully. Oops, that's too bright. Oh gosh. So, yep. All right. I will demold in the morning when I've got some lovely sunshine coming through my window. I'll have to do it early before the builders get here. All right. Thanks so much, guys. I will see you tomorrow. Oh, your phone. My gosh. Throw you in the resin in a minute. Oh, the joys of videoing. All right. See you tomorrow. So it's the next day. It's time to unmold these babies. It's bright and early. It's only, I think it's about 6:45 in the morning. Nice and early before the builders get here. Sun is shining, yay! It's a bit overcast, and we're supposed to be getting some rain, it says, but so far so good. Oh, this one's a little bit stuck, hang on, let me just grab that out. Right, it was just a little bit stuck, and just had to pick it up and get it out. Right, there we go, let's pop that there. Move my mold, and hopefully these have turned out really pretty. I'm so excited to see the backs. Alrighty, let's have a look. Actually, let's have a little close up of this side first. Love how we get that orange, and then it gets like a dark yellow, and then a light yellow, and then the white. Hopefully that's going to look really pretty on the other side. Just move you out of the way for a minute. I'm going to put my black on the back. I don't have a piece of black that's the same shape. I'm going to have to actually cut one. All right, let's do this. One, two, three. Oh, wow. Look at that, you guys. Oh, that is amazing. Wow. Can't stop looking at it. That is so pretty. So you get a totally different look though by doing the piping the circles is when you get the stick and you do this. Because when you get the stick, you get like a blob and then you thin it out, and a blob and you thin it out, and a blob and then you thin it out when you do that. So it's much more sort of, I don't know, it's each piece, each little petal is a bit different, whereas these, they're all the same. So it's a much more consistent look. But oh my gosh, that is so pretty. I love it. Just a hint of brown in the middle. This is what I wanted. I didn't want it to be too bright. You know how I said there, sometimes it's just so bright, you can hardly see the petals, because it's just way too much color. So that's what it looks like without the black background, which I can show you with white. Not as dramatic. Love it. All right, let's have a look at this one. Same. Don't you love how the orange goes off to the little points there? I love that. I love it, I love it, I love it. Oh, this is so exciting. All right, here we go with the next one. I won't do the countdown because it's going to be the same. All right, I'll move you out of the way so my camera can focus on this and not that. Here we go. Ta-da! Oh, it's so beautiful. Oh, I love these, you guys. It's exactly the same as the other one. It is exactly the same. And you can see, you can kind of see where, you know, I've pulled the stick through there. You can kind of see that. What do you think, hey? So pretty. Love them, love them, love them. Right, so that's them done. Hope you enjoyed that little video. I'm really, really surprised, happy with the 360 Plus. I didn't really think that it would work as well. Because when I started doing these 3D blooms, I used the Platinum Ultra Clear, and then I waited and I waited and I waited. You have to wait about an hour, but then I thought, oh, I'll try the 360, and I did a few fails, I must say, but now I think I've worked it out, and yeah, it looks pretty perfect. This one seems a little bit more orange. It's probably my favorite. See, it's got more orange in it. This one's got, it's not quite as orange around there, so that's my favorite. Love it. All right, guys, thank you so much. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please share. I'd love you to share if you can. I know it's a pain. People ask me to share, and I think, do I have to? It's a pain. But anyway, do what you can. I'd love it. All right, show your appreciation to my videos, and I will see you real soon for the next one. All right, love you all. Take care. Bye for now.